Diabetic Foot and Wound Service started in 2012 in response to the increasing number of diabetic patients coming in with foot ulcers who are at risk for amputations. And basically, when we started this program, what we found was that we were able to take care of patients in the hospital, but once they were discharged and they needed follow-up, it was exceedingly difficult for the patients to see all the different providers that were necessary. So what we did was we created one single multidisciplinary clinic and service that combines vascular surgery, surgical podiatry, and endocrinology that works on both the inpatient and the outpatient side. On the outpatient side, basically patients come and they see all three providers at a single visit. So they're not going to one visit with the podiatrist, one visit with the vascular surgeon, and one with the endocrinologist. They see us all at every single visit. At those visits, we also have a certified wound nurse, as well as a PA who helps us in our clinic coordinating care on the outpatient side.
On the inpatient side, all patients are evaluated by all members of our team. They are provided a vascular assessment with revascularization of their legs whenever needed. When patients have blockages in their arteries, we can help open them up to improve their wound healing and help save their limbs. The surgical podiatrist works with the patient to provide a wound care plan and wound debridements whenever necessary. Our wound care nurse sees the patients daily and helps with daily wound care changes. Our endocrinologist is involved in blood sugar control and helps get the patients to a manageable level to improve their wound healing potential. Finally, our infectious disease doctors work with us to provide antibiotic recommendations so that we can reduce infections and help save patients' limbs.
The philosophy of care is relatively simple. Patients with diabetic foot ulcers are at risk for losing their legs or major amputation. And the idea is that diabetic patients have multiple risk factors. They may have high glucose levels, called hyperglycemia. They may have peripheral vascular disease, which is also blockages of the arteries. Or they may have neuropathy of the feet, where they can't feel their feet, and so they're at risk for developing ulcers. The idea is that if we address each of these factors, that we're more likely to help a patient heal their wound and prevent a major amputation.
We provide many cutting-edge treatments in our diabetic foot and wound service. As vascular surgeons, we can treat patients using minimally invasive techniques or open surgery depending on what is needed based on the patient's anatomy. We used balloons, drug-coated balloons, and drug-coated stents for minimally invasive techniques. We also can do open leg bypasses when that's important or necessary. Our wound care nurse and surgical podiatrist have cutting-edge wound care treatments that are not used elsewhere in the country. They're constantly using different elements for wound care, and these have resulted in excellent wound healing rates compared to other programs across the country.
What's completely different about our program compared to other places around the country is that we follow our outcomes. We do an extensive amount of research, and we've published on this, and you can see it on our website, that looks at major amputation rates depending on what stage a patient comes in with their foot ulcer and the risk of amputation for that limb. And if you compare stage 4 patients across the country, we have one of the lowest, if not the lowest, major amputation rate in the country.
The most important aspect of our research is the long-term outcomes of the patients that we treat. We've been treating patients with the Diabetic Foot and Wound Service since 2012, so we have more than 5 years worth of outcomes. The majority of our patients follow up with us long-term, and we track their outcomes, including wound healing time, major amputation, and recurrent ulcers over time. This allows us to tailor the patient's individual care, as well as to learn about the treatments that we've provided in the past and understand what treatments might be better in the future.